Been out and I dress in trees. I'm not worried about back and forth. Made a mortgage from House and Beats. The devil, you balcony. Got a chopper, I never squeak. Know I holla, I play with keys. And my drummer brought at your feet. But back to that rapper shit. The backpack, not that trapper shit. I'm a dick.
How y'all doing, family? This is Chris Rod with Media TV, and I'm gonna be coming to you with this news from this little quick video. It says, man sentenced to life for killing wife, dumping her body. Damn. That's evil as fuck. You gonna kill your wife, and then you gonna dump your body? Damn, what would make you want to kill your wife? Shit, that's just fucking evil. Man, y'all gotta watch out who y'all be marrying and stuff like that. Motherfuckers killing they lovers and shit like that, they husbands and they wives and all kind of shit like that for insurance monies and setting up motherfuckers and all kind of shit. So y'all watch out who y'all marrying and stuff like that. They got some scandalous motherfuckers out here.
And it's life in prison for Sid Torres, the man at the center of a highly complicated and at times bizarre murder case in Broward County. He was convicted of killing his estranged wife, even though her body was never found. CBS 4's Hank Tester is live in Fort Lauderdale with reaction to today's sentencing. Hank.
And, you know, I think probably people will remember this because the search for the body went on forever. And Sid Torres, of course, was still in looking for the body, supposedly. There was just a lot of things that happened during this particular case that were just downright strange, including his behavior in the courtroom. Let's take a look. It was a long time coming. Last summer, Sid Torres found guilty of murdering his wife, Villette. She'd been dating another man. Torres was set to be sentenced months ago, but this happened in court. Torres started babbling.
Under our chief, the witch hunt ends here.
So you want to tell this to somebody?
And to the commander-in-chief, to the first lady.
That got Torres a mental health evaluation and brought the judicial process to a halt. Torres convicted even though his wife's body was never found. Prosecutors believe the victim was dumped in the Everglades. And what ails Sid Torres?
It certainly looks like there was some form of severe depression that resulted in these psychotic symptoms directly as a result of the legal situation.
Psychologist Dr. Michael Bannon testified that the legal proceedings led to Torres having paranoid delusional disorder, normally treated with drugs and therapy. Prosecutors called Torres a manipulator and suggested a solution.
That prison for the rest of his life will provide Sid Torres with a residential psychiatric setting where he will be monitored forever.
The judge agreed with that life sentence idea. Torres' attorney disappointed.
I was looking for a sentence that was certainly less than life in prison. You know, we're extremely disappointed with the sentence. However, this is not the end of the road for Mr. Torres.
Well, likely there's going to be an appeal. Now, Torres' family, his family says that he's innocent. But remember, in the trial, his children testified against him. That's the very latest. I'm Hank Tester, CBS 4. Back to you.
Damn. So, shit. Hold on, family, right quick. Let me hurry up and this shit is.
And it's life in prison.
Yeah, so that shit crazy. Motherfucker gonna get life in prison. But check this out, family. Okay. Now see what they say. They say mental psychotic illness or some kind of shit like that or whatever. Okay. Now he gonna get life in prison and shit like that. Now, how the fuck when these other white people Well, he's Mexican and shit Spanish. But how the fuck when white people do these mental illness shit like that, they go to jail, but they not they don't go to jail. They don't go to jail and being that motherfucker for life. They get out maybe after 5 to 10 years, 15 years or whatever, and they have, you know, probation. They can get out and stuff like that. But him, he killed his wife. I'm not saying, you know what I'm saying, I'm not advocating. I ain't saying I'm standing with him for killing his wife because I don't believe he shouldn't have done anything like that, you know, and stuff like that. I ain't with him for anything. But it's just crazy, you know, how they do certain things for certain people. You know, you already know, if you ain't white, they ain't gonna, you know, they ain't gonna bend the rules for you. But if you black or you Hispanic or anything like that, you already know they're gonna throw the whole fucking book at your ass and make sure you fucking stay in there. So they never, the fucking system is never fair. It's never fair. It's always loopholes of fuckery and trying to make sure they throw the whole book at the black man and everything. And it's very always fucking racist towards us. Anything we fucking do. But family, this is a crazy ass fucking story. I don't know why the fuck he would do something like that. But they said they couldn't find her body. But hey, if they think you did it, bruh, and you can't, you know, prove that you didn't do it, but you got the kids came and testified against you, that's what made it, that's what damn near sold the deal, you feel what I'm saying? So, that shit is crazy. But, family, y'all let me know what y'all think in the comment board. Y'all drop a like, subscribe to the channel. Donate to my PayPal at firemanpbc@gmail.com. That's fireman, FIREMANPBC@gmail.com. My PayPal account. And y'all have a great night, family. Love y'all. Y'all have, and I'll be back with another one.